He told me, in the last days, the hidden ones are going to come out. They're going to come out, and they're going to work together with the sanctified ones in the church. And if they're going to work, you must have a working knowledge of the existence of such a company. You know, John did not die, right? The Bible says, no, he did not die. So if he did not die, how old is he now? 2,000 years, right? I've seen him several times. He looks nice, handsome, like how he last was, you know. You see, you appear at the last age of your time before you are transformed. You appear like that, like your age is freeze. You're bald headed, you're bald headed. Sorry about that. But whatever you look like in the physical, that's how you are freeze framed, freezed. And that's how you look like in the glory. But of course, in heaven, you may look more glorious, you know. But we are talking about now. Till we all go there. These are the many, many glorious things, you know, reserved for the last day's church. Eye hath not seen, ear hath not heard, neither has it entered into the mind that which God has reserved for the last days. There is no precedent for what God is going to do in the last days. There's no precedent. So you cannot go back to any point in history to make a comparison to say, did it happen in Bible days? It does not. You cannot look for any comparison. God is going to reveal many truths in the last days. And there won't be any precedent. So you can't go and see where is it written in the Bible. You can't look. So what? How can we know that this revelation that we receive is not from the devil and is from the Holy Spirit? How do we know? Because there's no comparison. The ultimate test is the Holy Spirit bearing witness with your spirit what you are receiving. See, any true revelation, whether it came from an angel or a saint or from the Holy Spirit or from the Lord Jesus or from even the Father God, there are some basic principles in the scripture that will not be violated. Basic grounds, you know. See, like, let me give you one example. The Lord Jesus said, when the Holy Spirit comes, he will not speak of himself, but he will speak of me.